Selector, and where are we there? Okay, yes, that's looking good. Okay, let's go. Hey, right, I can turn that thing off. It says PTV start. Let's sort of get into the camera zone. I've got a new little camera here, and we're gonna say hello to people now. We're gonna go back to where's Resolume. Up, yeah, there we're on screen. Goody. Okay, yeah, it's a little bit dark. I wonder if I can. This new camera's a bit. Did you put your Ninja logo on the back of the Mac there?
Yep.
Maybe it needs an extra one. The apple's still shining through. Pod people, we are getting going. I can see some pirates in the house already. Oh, a kiss from Paris from Erwin Perron. Thank you there. And Ashley Whiteman is shouting out to George Fields, Aid Huntingford, genuine and number one pirates in the area. And so is another number one pirate, Marty Wells, who we've got here on Twitch. Ratboy, the one and only. Yes, you're there first in the Twitch, Ratboy. Respect to you. Johnny Sod, Dr. Deej, Ubiquity Lab. Fellas, and first time chat from viewer Mini Limmy. Good evening to you. Thwack my bonobo from Portland. And Olive, hello, happy Wednesday to you, Olive. And Rodai, yes indeed. Right, I'm not sure where I'm looking here, but I've got to look here, If I just turn, maybe crank a bit more brightness out of this. Let's see if I can turn this up. You alright, Morris?
Yeah, good. hello everyone.
That's our only monitor, that little one there. That's the best I can do for the moment.
Oh yeah.
Where's the brightness gone? Okay, I'll have to drop one on. Just a bit more, yeah, not too much, a bit more of that, a bit more contrast, how about that? Okay, my pirates, we are rocking and rolling. I'm Matt Black, or Altered Fist sometimes call myself, and this
I'm
is
Mixmaster Morris.
Mixmaster Morris, the Irresistible Force. Who you know well. And once more, a special with Mixmaster Morris, and this week we are going to. What are we going to do this week, Morris?
I think we're going to pay tribute to the man called Luke Vibert.
Alias?
Alias. Wagon Christ, alias
Plug,
Carrier
yes.
District, alias Mike and Rich with Apex Twin, alias Vibert and Simmons, alias a whole lot of other names actually. I went to look today, see how many Luke Vibert albums there were, and I think I lost count at about 30. So we weren't
including a bunch of new ones, right?
There's a whole bunch of new ones, yeah. I don't think the guy ever goes to sleep. He told me 30 years ago he made a track every single day, and I have no reason to doubt it.
Respect. Well, I did have a phone number for Luke, and I pinged at him, but I didn't get hold of him. But I heard from my man Callum that Luke had reposted it on his Facebook page.
Right, cool.
So he must have reached out.
Well, I gave you that number, and it's pretty old, I think.
Yeah, and you never know. He might beam in here on the... on the chat.
He is doing a big party this weekend, I think, in Manchester, like warehouse project or something.
Okay.
So.
Okay, well, Mr. Vibert.
Yeah. The wagon keeps rolling.
The wagon keeps rolling. If you're out there, it'd be lovely to see you pop up on the chat, but either way, we're feeling you, and Morris has put together a bunch of tracks, and we'll just chat and play some music and mix some visuals and keep the wagon rolling.
Well, do you want it in chronological order? I thought of doing maybe to start with a whole chunk of stuff from when he was with me on Rising High Records in the early 90s.
Yeah, that'd be a great start, and you can talk about that time.
Yeah,
and
talk
stuff.
About that, and then do the late 90s, okay. And then do the 2000s after that.
Sounds good.
But I must say, with the new stuff, I really don't know it very well, so I'll be winging it.
Well, we always wing it a bit here on Pirate TV, so that is fine. Good and dandy. I hope everyone tuning in has been having a groovy week since the last Pirate TV. Actually, I took a break, didn't I? Sorry about that. Last week, was feeling a bit under the weather and needed to recover from a little medical thing. So, but back here this week on full power with MMM. And actually, we're going to have a little competition this week. And on offer, I'll go and get it in a minute. We are going to have a signed copy of the Cold Cut and Mixmaster Morris mix of At Zero. We're going to sign it, and we're going to think of some stupidly hard competition to, because otherwise everyone can do everything on Google nowadays, so it can't be anything factual like that, but we'll think of something. Do remind us, shout it in the chat if I forget about it. It'll be towards the latter half of the show, I think. Keep you all tuned in. And exclusive one, there's only currently one of those in existence. So signed CD mix from Mixmaster and Cold Cut of that At Zero ambient album is coming up later on in the show.
Yeah, I just got my copies today, so it's on the way.
Happy with your credit?
I'm happy to feel it, yes. It looks nice. I haven't played it yet, but it looks good.
Cool. Yes, indeed. And actually, we've the vinyl is also looking quite good as well. I think it's immediately sold out.
I think it's immediately sold out. I've just had a call from a shop in Japan, and they're absolutely going berserk because they haven't got any copies, and they want to send them a box immediately.
Rewind, repress.
That's right.
Good. Well, it's a nice problem to have.
Yeah.
Let's have a quick more shout out to Elsa's themed in. Tusker Musicus, welcome. Cat Cooper, hi there. All streaming in there on the chat. Yeah, don't forget to give us some signal in the chat. Or that's the hipsters call it now, the shout box. I picked that one up. Always been on a bit of a jargon watch. Tech Amp in the house. Croissant. Pablo 23. Zelimar, ahoy to you, Electro Elvis, and Dr. Deidre saying he loved the 808 State mix. I've been getting some good love on Mixdown, I think.
It has, and today 808 State posted it on their own Twitter account.
So. Oh, there you go.
Yeah, and followed me.
So, RIP Andy Barker, 808 State, and Graham Massey's a mate of ours who haven't seen him for a few years. I hope he's doing good. And, sad
there
loss.
Is an 808 tour, I think, still going ahead. So
I mean, Graham's definitely active still.
Yeah, I think they're just going ahead with the tour.
Next tune.
Well, this is actually the tune that got him signed in the first place.
To Rising High.
To Rising High, because I sat with Casper Pound listening to demos. And as you can imagine, you know, with the techno label back then, we didn't have to get a lot of terrible music.
Well, I mean,
really bad.
Probably less demos than we have nowadays, to be quite honest. But
cassette
demo. Those were the days.
Indeed, famously, Aphex Twin sent us a cassette demo with one track on it, but he packed it inside a 7-foot drain pipe stuffed with loads of waste paper. So it took us about 2 hours to get the tape out of the tube. And then the tape was like a sort of 50p. Bargain bin cassette, you know, that falls apart.
Yes, sound no
labels.
Or something like that.
Yeah, there was one track on it and it wasn't really very good.
But so the packaging was good.
I think he was just trolling us. But then again, I think he's usually just trolling us.
Trolls weren't invented in those days.
I think Richard was the first.
He was a proto troll,
I could give you lots of examples.
Well, he has played a very good game. If winding up people is an art form, then
he is a genius.
He's a genius, absolutely. We say that with all love. What's this one called then?
This is Lapping Up Space Milk from the Sunset Boulevard EP, which I think this was the first EP, but maybe At Atmos was the first. Somebody with Discogs will tell us. But we're going to play both of those, and then we'll have tracks from his Rising High albums like Fat Lab Nightmare.
Oh, I love that. I've always thought that was a great genre. This Fat Lab as a genre, you know what I mean?
And also I've got here the Vibert and Simmons album from 93, which I remember I was immensely into all those years ago and haven't really played it since, actually. Definitely way out on the left field.
Do that kind of thing. This is my little visuals controller, rather useful, like these Korg, a few years old now, but very useful, the Korg micro control series. I'm going to put this one here and use that as a fader box for the visuals. So if I do that, I can take that up and I can bring that up and I can bring it up a little bit in the mix. A bit more Vega in the background. So when you heard the Luke Vibert demo, did it stand out?
Yeah, definitely. When we heard this, we were just falling about laughing, and at the end we all just said, you've got to get this guy, he's brilliant.
You know these soft machines? The 808, the 808 and the 303. Those, Luke turned me onto those. He was sitting here, this was when Ninja Jam first came out, it was about 7 years ago, and I invited him over and we sat down there and had a jam together. And he'd got one of these cushions, so I had to get one as well. Pretty decent. We love our soft machines. Space Dog is very well, thank you, Olive. Let's hear from Space Dog quickly. Checking him out. Where are we? Yes. Alright. Oh yeah. Cool. I wouldn't see it there, would I? Because it's here. There's Space Dog. He is giving you a big and soft kiss. And you know, Olive, we've been trying to get your icons onto Twitch. And the short version is, you only can put your icons on if you're sort of a registered account holder thing, which we are doing, but then you have to put in all your tax information and basically it's a huge ball ache, but we're still working on it. The Redoubtable Callum and the Ninja Tune Accounts team have joined forces to solve that problem. How can we do that? Yay! big up to all the people also listening on Twitter, our new platform there. And I'm not sure if Mixcloud is actually working. It's not reporting the viewers here, but YouTube as well. There's a few pirates watching there. Big up to you.
Parts of the internet crashing the last couple of days. Spotify was down yesterday all day.
Really?
Loads of people were saying, right, I'm going to get my records out now. I can't manage without it.
The electric goes off, you get the gas light out. When the internet goes off, you get your vinyl out.
Yeah.
I got the, this is a pack for jam that we made.
Oh, right.
In the early days, a rather wonderfully named Approaching Cloth from Luke. He sent us a bunch of outtakes. And
he does have some good titles, doesn't he?
He does have some good
titles. I've just seen his John Peel session, and he has a track called REO Speed Garage.
And
you have to kind of like somebody who would call a track. I heard a good story about REO Speedwagon. Apparently, they were booked in some huge California studio to make an album, and they spent 8 weeks playing ping pong at the cost of $15,000 a day.
Pretty rock and roll.
Cool. Yep.
Hey, Filter Sequence, good evening to you. And yes, Ashley Whiteman, we definitely did have Luke DJing at Stealth. That was in the old days of Ninja Tune, when the world was young and everything sounded good.
Okay, I want to tell you this. Rob DeBank, who we all love.
Yeah.
There's been a thing going around where you put what's the best club you've ever been to, best 10 clubs you've ever been to, and Rob DeBank did his, and he put Stealth as number 2 best club of all time. Should have been.
Thanks, Rob.
Should have been number 1.
Well, number I think
two
it's will, still
number
result,
2 is so. Fair enough.
Okay. I'm not going to ask what number 1 was.
It was Rage at Heaven, actually.
Well, what would you say? Was that a good party? I wasn't there.
I'm not sure. I was at Heaven a lot. I'm not sure if I was at Rage. I used to go and see Colin Favor at Heaven. Was that a Rage?
Don't know.
Really? Yeah.
We love Rob DeBank.
Yeah. We love Heaven too. I just wish it would come back. Come back to music. Come back to some live acts and things at Heaven. I think that's actually going to happen. I think there's going to be live gigs at Heaven.
Right.
The last 10 years it's been kind of Eurovision.
Yeah, I mean, you know, let's face it, the gay party scene was a huge progressive force, right, in the beginning of house and today's dance music scene.
Yeah, the problem is that gay club owners tend to be members of the Conservative Party, literally.
Ouch.
Well, that's literally the case with many of them, and so not surprisingly, their idea of music is not very developed.
No, but, well, okay, I mean, this isn't New York, I suppose, but some, you know...
A homo block is the exception, you know, and that's a step forward. Up north, they're getting it a bit better now.
Yeah.
But I've heard some truly terrible music at gay clubs in London the last 30 years. I mean, generally, it's been awful. I remember standing in trade, crying my eyes out, thinking, "This is everybody else is having the most fantastic time," and you know, I just think this is the naffest, cheesiest music I've ever heard in my life.
I know that.
It is Sir Noise devoid of funk, writ large.
Listen, I'm going to suggest that you actually mix into the next track. And I'm going to mix a bit of visuals, and so we don't chat through all the music, although I think our chat is okay and people like it. But let's do a bit of AV mixing as well, okay? Let's say Mega Trip to Set Heaven, Holly Revest. Yes, that was a thing, wasn't it? Hey, Tom Mini, yo! One of my oldest mates and compatriots has just jumped up there on the chat. Hi there, Tom. MV Shari is shouting out to Kev Gaynor. And oh, Vinnie Technoman from New Haven, Michigan. Oi, good, right. Across the tracks, round the world. We're sending the love out to all you pirates. And really nice to hear from you where you are, actually. Don't forget to give us a shout, signal of your location here. thing and smash that. Maybe I need to swap it over. I think it's alright, isn't it? First time chat from viewer Monio 888. Good evening to you. And Poland's in the house with Robert Piasta. Great. Yes, indeed. The audio is very left heavy. Okay, thank you for that. Thank you for the feedback there. And a little nudge on the balance control. And that should be equalised a bit more. How's it looking on your meters? Can you see? Got stereo meters?
No, I already got mono meters.
Okay, well, thanks for the feedback there. Dr. Deej, you can give us some signal if it's better, actually.
You can see it's better.
Oh, no, wait a moment. Actually, I think there might be a problem here. Yeah, I think we might have had a loose connection there.
Not a loose connection.
We need a loose connection, but we had a loose connection. But now we've tightened it up. Pirates, let us know if that is looking more central again there. Hello, Quint the Mint from Nottingham. Welcome to you. Atomic Lady Studio in Berlin is where Ubiquity Labs at. Fantastic. Okay, yeah, Dan Hess, I think we've sorted the lack of stereo there. Good always to give us that signal and remind us how we're doing, because it's quite difficult to get the balance here because we're just making it up as we go along and it is a bit ad hoc, but we get the job done. Okay, roll. Better. Thank you, Dan Hess. Good. Thank you, Rodi. Keep that chat going. Same situation, yeah, okay. We sorted it. Something's frozen up here on YouTube, on their Facebook. What's going on there? I'm going to scroll that out. Luke is competing with the microphones. Who's winning, Marty? Yeah, we wobbled our phono cables, actually. That's what we did, and we've sorted it. Thank you, Filter Sequence. What was I saying? Yeah, let's have a mix. And let's. I'm going to mix in some visuals now we've sorted that. And Rat Boy, your video is coming up. No, it's not, because I haven't downloaded it. I tell you what. Paste it in the chat, Rat Boy, and I'll try and download it now. I will not guarantee. Georgios Paraglou from Greece, yay. Luke had the upper hand, okay. So let's make sure we're on balance then. It's gonna fade us out. Getting some nice particles like that. Do a little mix, get some other shit going. Vicious. How's that? Yeah. Synchronize that.
Tell you something, I went down to Rye Wax about 2 years ago because they had like some young guys doing an ambient night from New Atlantis. So I thought I'll go and see what the young kids think of as ambient music nowadays. Uh-huh. Uh-huh. And I got in there and they were playing this record that I released 27 years ago. And I was like, oh, hey.
Shows excellent taste. Yeah.
And this is Fat Lab Nightmare.
The track.
This is the first track, Mahadelic.
Right.
And this is literally what they were playing as I walked into the club.
When was that?
2 years ago.
Good.
What's the posse called? I heard Rye Wax is gone.
Rye Wax?
Yeah. Fantastic shop in Peckham.
Ah, I heard of it, yeah. Okay, well, respect to the guys who put that together. Perhaps they will return at some juncture. That would be good. we'll just warp out like that. And again, warp out, come back to the heart. Got a new microphone for Morris this week, so it's like my one. It's like so even as he nods backwards and forwards, he still stays in the same position. Special, we're on Pirate TV. Synapse to Synapse every Wednesday night. Mixmaster Morris on the mix. What about that? Is that going to work? Something's building. Yeah. Hey there, Mercedes. Not sure about the red vinyl there, Nicola. It might have been. So Morris has just gone to the loo. I'll ask him when he comes back. Apex Angel. Good to see you.
Rising high, we gave people a chance to do whatever they wanted, and this is what he wanted to do in 1993.
Beautiful track. Thank you.
Boy. I'm not going to play it this week because we're doing a Luke Vibert special, but I will endeavour to check it out and play it next week. I do like your stuff. This is a themed week, so... Actually, I might play a bit of...
Vibert is actually his real name, despite lots of people assuming that he must have chosen it.
Pretty unusual name, Vibert. What's the name of this?
So, moving on now to his second album, Throbbing Pouch. Is that right? Did we not have three albums on Rising High? Okay. Maybe the plug album, I'm thinking of that as an album. Mm-hmm. I think I possibly have missed out an album. But there are so many albums, we can miss out a few, it doesn't matter.
Well, there's more Wang Price than we can get through in 2 hours, that's for sure.
There is. Well, let me estimate. 7, 4, 11, 13... I have 22 hours of Luke Vibert tracks here. And that's not by any means everything. If you'd like to hire me for a 22-hour Luke Vibert set, then we could discuss terms.
Sure. I'm just playing some visuals off this. It's sort of pretty weird when the average robot advert might actually be a Luke Vibert video. I'm going to come back with a little cat rumba video in a bit. Talking, you keep mixing in the background, Morris, okay?
Yeah. Well, okay. Amongst the news, there's quite a lot. Steve Bannon's been arrested.
Steve Bannon's been arrested?
Yes, by the FBI.
By the FBI?
Yeah.
I'm sorry, but I have to say good to that.
The QAnon shaman got 3 years in jail. Doesn't seem much for trying to overthrow the government, but he is a white person. No doubt he had a hard life.
Yeah, true.
He was
words.
Demanding vegan food while in prison, wasn't he? And his mum staged a sit-down strike to demand that he got... Well, I think organic food he had to have, because he's a very important person, you know.
I'm not sure I know... I know who QAnon is, but...
In America.
I like your trousers, by the way.
What?
I like your trousers. Very nice. But you can stand up so people can see them. Look, he's got some nice trousers.
They are Japanese room pants from Uniqlo. Cost about £8. So these ones are sadly worn out, I've got to say. I think this is their last outing.
Well, the moths have been at them. Special request to Katya last night. We were down at Cafe Otto, which is...
Oh, lovely place.
Lovely place. Probably London's leading alternative out there venue. Actually, Eleanor, who works at Ninja Tune, was saying she saw the orchestra there with her mum a couple of years ago. And I turned her on to that documentary, A Joyful Noise.
A Joyful Noise.
And I've just downloaded, bought 7 Sun Ra albums on Bandcamp, actually, because I'm thinking of doing a mix. And I sampled lots of dialogue as well. Don't forget, you gave me that excellent ya-ya spoken word from
Resonance.
Yeah. I've been living off that for years. It's so cool. We're on a spaceship Earth. Destination and culture. Okay, I'm gonna not do the news in Dublin.
Actually, I'm overdue to do a Sun Ra mix for Mixcloud. But if you think Luke Vibert's catalogue is big, a friend of mine made it his life's work to do a discography of Sun Ra, and he actually went insane after about 5 years.
Do you know Erwin Jusint?
He reached about 410 albums, I think, before he gave up.
Do you know Erwin Jusint?
Yes.
He's the sort of official custodian of the archive at the moment.
He wrote the book.
Yeah, he's also Raymond Scott's great booster as well.
That's right. And the Raymond Scott archive is very happy with me because I did a very nice Raymond Scott mix last month.
Cool.
And I finally heard the Electronium tracks, which I hadn't heard before, including the Motown one.
Yeah, they're pretty great,
amazing,
aren't they?
Barry Gordy gave him £1 million.
I know the story.
Barry Gordy didn't give anybody anything without a good reason.
He was a smart guy. But little note here. A couple of years ago, we signed a new artist to Ninja Tune who we'd been pursuing for quite a while. And his name was Sam Floating Points. And we want to give him a special present to welcome him here. We could get him a little synth, but he's got loads of synths. So I suggested that he might be interested in, if he's into synths and weirdo electronic stuff, he'd be into Raymond Scott. So I had a book which I got called Artifacts from the Archives, which was a book of all Scott's writings and diagrams and weird stuff. So
I got
Erwin sent me a copy, refused to let me pay for it, and we gave it to Sam, and then I didn't hear any more. And then I met up with him at a gig, and I asked him, "Did you like the book?" He said, "I read every word." He took it, so that was nice. Okay, let me get down with the news. Where's my sheet here? Fade myself out. Put on a bit of web page. Here we go.
There's a lot of news. There's COP26.
Yeah, am I going to play this? I think I am. Why is that not coming up? That's the way that Boris Johnson's best heard, actually.
There is a Labour Party 5 points ahead of the opinion poll this week.
Well, it would be if it were true, but it's just another lie. CO2 emissions fell by 39% between 1990 and 2018, not from 2010 onwards.
Under this Conservative government, has grown by 73%.
Another lie. In the period since 2010 and prior to the pandemic, it was about 20%. The 73% he's referring to is for the whole period since 1990, 13 years of which was under Labour governments.
We've restored the nurses' bursary.
Another lie. A maintenance grant for student nurses is not a return of the student nurses' bursary. Thanks to the Conservative government scrapping the nurses' bursary, they still have to pay extortionate tuition fees and still qualify tens of thousands of pounds in debt.
And ensure there will be a free hospital car parking for everybody who attends a hospital.
Just another lie.
Absolute poverty, relative poverty have both declined under this government, and there are hundreds of thousands, I think 400,000 fewer families living in poverty now than there were in 2010.
More lies. The number of people in relative poverty in the UK has increased from 13.6 million in 2010 to 14.5 million in 2019. And as for his claim that 400,000 fewer families are living in poverty, well, it appears he just made that up.
The app would be the icing on the cake. Well, if we can get it to work, it would be a fine thing, but there isn't one anywhere in the world so far.
Another lie. At the time, track and trace apps were being used in France, Germany, Australia, Poland, Latvia, Denmark, Japan, Italy.
He will know that the government is engaged in record investments in the NHS, £34 billion.
Another lie. In real terms, it's a spending increase of just £20.5 billion. The Institute for Fiscal Studies points out that's less than funding used to rise under Labour.
Yeah, I think you get the idea. Another lie. Well done, Peter Stefanovic, for pointing that one out. And as Quint the Mint just pointed out, Boris does sound great at zero volume. Let's pump up that a little bit more. Have a little wah wah wah. And so a very, very brief quick news from COP26, I'm sure we're all like highly disappointed by the complete failures or almost complete failure of our leaders, the corporations and the government to phase out fossil fuels. 190 nations and organisations agreed to phase out fuels. And it was looking quite good until China and India basically said, no, we're not going to do it and we're not going to phase it out. You'll have to say phase it down or we're not signing. Coal is the most polluting fossil fuel. I think coal is well in the firing line now and the sort of pennies slowly dropping, but basically it was a bit shit. This was faintly encouraging, did I? What's up? My call. Might have reported this last week. China and the USA announced plans to work together. And it's... I don't know. They say stuff, don't they? But they don't do stuff usually, so...
Blah, blah, blah.
Yeah, as Greta said. Yes, indeed. The Pacific inhabitants of our planet, our Pacific brothers and sisters, are going to be drowned out by the failure of us to sort it out. So, particularly disappointed by softened language on coal and a dwindling a lack of funding to pay for loss and damages. There was another one about that. I think actually a couple of billion or something has finally been agreed to help out. The poorest countries are going to be worse clobbered. Moving on.
And one thing about COP26, I read that there was actually more delegates representing the oil industry and the fossil fuel industry than from any other country.
Yeah, that would
be. They had the largest delegation.
Well, they are the largest, loudest voice, aren't they, basically?
Okay, well, yeah. Not surprisingly, they voted to find themselves not guilty,
yes.
Just like the Tories.
Yep. Yeah, nice bit of news here. I think we've been reporting on this for a while. Psychedelic medications keep gaining more support, evidence, science-based evidence for their value. Largest ever clinical trial of psilocybin for depression treatment, especially in symptoms of people with hard-to-treat depression, the largest clinical trial of its kind to date. Great. So, as I say, gaining more support. A few pictures from COP with some other people who are acting and actioning. Lovely Greta. Just scroll through these quickly. Yeah, the bill, exactly. Save the planet. It's quite getting quite a popular sentiment that. Yeah, go on, what's this?
This is Nobukazu Takemura, who is a great Japanese don of the 90s, and actually the first Japanese new release record I ever bought was his single Crescent, remixed by Cold Cuts and Mad Professor, if you remember.
I remember.
On Bellissima Records, which is a fantastic track that's not been on any chill out albums as far as I know, so remind me to put that one on one.
I remember meeting up with him when we were in Japan, actually. There's a nice photo of us and Kev and the ninjas in Japan with him. A few more pictures there. I mean, you know, the activists were out in Glasgow and elsewhere, and they seemed to destroy the patriarchy on the planet. I went to the Royal College of Art summer show, which was postponed until recently. It was pretty amazing, and that is a show that anyone can enter work to with a chance of getting it shown. It's pretty some mind-blowing stuff. Let's just want to do one more item. Okay, if you want to take it off, just tell me, I'll mute you down. Expedia to stop selling holidays that include captive dolphin shows. And if anyone remembers that documentary Blackfish, that was quite mind-blowing. Think changed a lot of people's minds. Good. Halfway through the news. Let's have a bit of that. Yes. A link between being kind to others and happiness, UBC researcher says. Canada. By far one of the better countries to live, I reckon. Joins nearly 30 countries in celebrating World Kindness Day on Saturday. Goodie. studies have shown a causal link where when people behave in the generous, kind way, they actually end up being happier themselves, said Elizabeth Dunn, psychology professor and happiness researcher. Well, that's a good job, isn't it? Frankly, I find it very reassuring that humans have this sort of baked-in tendency to experience joy from helping others. Nice. World Kindness Day traces its origins to Tokyo, where it was first introduced as part of the World Kindness Movement in 1998. It's a day in November, so when is it? This Saturday. Okay, well, everyone, wishing you lots of happiness for Saturday, and let's try and keep a smile on my face all day long and do something nice for someone else. Okay, then we're halfway through the news.
It is constant.
Nice vocal.
It is constant.
What's this one then?
This is still
the Takemura. Just a sec.
Say again, mate. Still Nobukazu Takemura.
Remixing Wagon Quest. Yeah.
No, Wagon Quest remixing him.
Okay.
It was on an EP that had let's get it right. Aphex Twin mix, Ronnie Size mix, a Philip Glass mix, a Luke Vibert mix, and maybe a Black Dog mix. It was a long time ago, but
that's a pretty good lineup.
It was a pretty awesome lineup. But there was this wonderful moment in Japan where, when the Japanese just suddenly woke up to all this British music, and we all started to get gigs in Japan.
Most of us, unfortunately, that's dried up, but not for you.
I've never been more in demand in Japan.
Good. Long may it continue. So, actually, we were talking about whether we could get a Irresistible Force, and maybe me and Dinas could go over there and do some gigs with you.
Yeah, I'd love to do that.
I
still not open, the borders are still closed.
Are they?
Yep. Only just let students in about a week ago. And the students that are allowed in, they have to spend 14 days in a quarantine hotel, and they're being charged £150 a day for food, which seems a bit steep.
Harsh.
Seen a lot of people grumbling about that. There's a massive jazz festival in Tokyo this weekend at Ageha, which is the biggest club in the whole country.
We've played there.
I've played there. Have you played there? Ageha? Yeah. It's out in the Docklands.
That's where we did the Ninja 20th party.
No, that was in Shibuya. Ageha's like 20 miles away to the east. Ageha, you have to get a shuttle bus there because it's so far away. They provide a free bus service all night from the centre, which is a really good idea if you've got a club in the middle of nowhere.
I think we might have done that gig. I think it was the biggest club, apparently.
It wasn't. Didn't exist in 97, in 99 when we did the 20th. Oh, hang on, that wasn't the 20th then, was it?
No, it was 2010.
Right. Mm. Well, Ageha's got a pool. It's got a swimming pool outside. I played by the swimming pool the last time I did it.
Yes.
And it's huge. It's about 5,000 capacity.
Yes.
Yep.
Yes.
The most immense lighting truss I've ever seen in my life. It's like as big as a Glastonbury Festival or something. Huge. I played there with System 7. Was a really good night. Sold it out.
Yeah. Got to get together once more with Stephen Miquette. Do some music soon. Keep saying that. Anyway, they're well. Living in Glastonbury at the moment.
That's right.
Just crank down this. It's a little bit bright. Okay, so where are we at with Luke now?
We're still on this mix, but I think we can go to... I think we haven't... If we're doing it chronologically, we have to do Plug next, I think.
Yeah, let's have some
And then
plug,
we'll move on to when he was with Mo Wax and Virgin and labels like that for brief periods. He hasn't often been on a lot of record labels in his time, has he, Luke Vibert? I think one label is just not enough to deal with the output.
Yeah. Didn't he got approached by a sort of street vendor selling a new newspaper, sort of homeless guy selling his newspaper to make a few bob, and the paper's called Dope.
No.
I was like, why'd they call it that? I think she said that to him, but actually she ended up having a long chat with him. She brought it home. It's wicked. It's really sort of good, constructive socialist critique and full of information.
Well, that's a good name if you ask me.
Yeah, it's I'm warming to it. The content's excellent. It's like a sort of more hip, more out there big issue. And I just noticed, because in my notes here, talking about Kropotkin, if Donnie is tuning in, I met up at Climate Emergency Centre. Thanks for your turning me on to him.
Wasn't he an anarchist?
Well, yeah. He's more into cooperation and mutualism, which...
My Russian history is not all that spotless.
Is this plug?
No, but this is.
A bit more slurping, you should like. Is this? The camera might be a bit out of focus. Has this got a focusing thing on it? Oh, let's have a look. Impossible to do. Here I am interacting with the thing which I'm trying to alter. No, it doesn't look like it has. Okay. This is my ultra cheap webcam which just came today because I found that my expensive Brio 4K big slap to Logitech here. It's been causing me loads of problems, and quite a lot of the problems I've been having with Pirate TV have been down to problems with this 4K camera, which the couple of times you've been here, it's been really weird. The power's been running out on the computer, even though I've got it plugged into the super duper hub power supply. I found when I disconnected my Brio, it's working okay again. Mind you, we're down to 63% already. Oh, fuck. Should just about be okay. Maybe I'll take a break from Resolume for a sec. Yeah, that's what I'll do. Give it a chance to power up again. Oh. Okay. Have some Cotswold rainbow. Have some surfing sea lions, why don't we? Not drum and bass, not that it just started, but it was getting more avant-garde.
Well, I think this was the point where it got more avant-garde.
That's what I'm saying.
Yeah, it was 95, and it did literally blow a lot of people's minds, especially in America, where this album sold many, many, I think 100,000 in America or something.
You're joking, really? Yeah. Why is it?
Right. As did T-Power. And a lot of records that they didn't go in the UK, but they went in the States.
That's a slightly better balance there. Yeah, really, I always got the impression that drum and bass never really took off in the States.
You'd be wrong. It's huge. Like everything else, it's huge underground.
Yeah.
I mean, there isn't a town in America of more than 10,000 people that doesn't have a drum and bass DJ. I'm going to guarantee it to you.
Talking of the States, here is our man, Door Wand.
It's
nice
like reggae.
To see the Space Lab again. Let me just say hello to Door. Door,
hello, Door.
I remember you. So does Morris. You have jammed with us many a time in this very room that we're sitting in. Good to see you, mate. Check out Fault Radio. The Door runs in West Coast, where we're both checking into. Military Jazz caught the ear of this American, says Edward Pilke. Right.
And that's this track.
That's this track.
Yeah.
Nicely spotted there, Edward.
And the EP is called Rebuilt Kev, which is certainly a remix of Luke Fiber, an anagram. But I'm wondering what Visible Crater Funk is an anagram of, because it has all the letters of Luke Vibert, but a few more. So somebody can work that out. The fact that could be a good question for the competition.
Okay, actually, all right, let's we'll flow with it.
It's probably obvious.
Okay, Morris has just pointed out that this, another plug track.
The first EP is called Visible Crater Funk.
The first plug EP, plug one, is called Visible Crater Funk, right? Now then, we're putting it out there. What is that an anagram of? Post it in the chat and you can win a signed copy of Absolute Zero. At zero compilation. What's happening here? Okay, yes. Okay, right. Yes. Hi there, Vex Angel. Amen. Break never gets worn out. As I say, it's got to be one of the
I see that Luke made an album last year called Amen Andrews.
Ooh. Luke Francis Viber equals versatile crib funk.
Visible crater funk, but that's the answer, isn't it? For sure, yeah.
Luke Francis Viber. I think we're going to...
The winner.
I think we're going to give that one to Edward Pilkey, actually.
Oh, you see, I didn't know his middle name, so you obviously out-nerded me on that.
Well done. I think possibly even... Yeah, well done, Edward. Okay, Edward, drop us a mail, jampro1000@gmail.com, and we will send you your CD. Well done. Nice one. Actually, let's hold that up. Do you think you can lean over there? It's just behind that box. There's a stack of CDs. And actually, no, the other side of it. That's right, but just the other side of it. Now bring that whole box over. Bring that whole box over. That and the box underneath it, please. Nice. Okay. Morris. And over there might be a pen, or it might be here. Gold pen. Yeah, I've got another one here. Hold on. Glitch factor 10. Yeah, it was round about this time in 95, whenever it was then. Some guy gave me a white label with a picture of a square with a dot in the middle of it. That was the first square pusher record. That was at Glastonbury. Oh look, we've trashed this, fuck. Oh well. Clip broken. Okay, we're gonna... Do you want to sign that? I've just turned you down. Back up. Back up now, mate. Marty Wells likes his snares Venetian. Indeed, they are quite Venetian, these, aren't they? Yeah. And let's see. I'm going to sign this to Edward. Probably can hardly see that, Edward, but that is for you, and that will be winging your way to you when we get your details. Well played. Fast on the buttons. I don't know if you've got access to some online anagram solver there, but anyway, you beat everyone else to it. And Morris, I've got a little present for you, actually. Yeah, so as you're working on your new album, little birdie told me that you've started three tracks.
Four, actually.
Goody. Of course, it's all about...
You've got to start before you can finish.
Yeah, but it's also all about finishing tracks, though. Let's not forget it.
But starting is sometimes the hardest bit. Finishing is quite hard, too. You've got to get started before you can approach the finish.
Next. Okay. Mix Master Morris, we have got a little special present to help you on your way with a fantastic album that I know that you're going to make for us, Irresistible Force, for you.
Ah, man, bloody
Zen
fantastic.
Delay.
Look at that, brilliant.
I thought, I've got a box of a couple of them sitting here, I thought there's no point in them sitting under the table when
and
they could be working.
It actually has a valve in it.
It has a valve, it and the valve, valve. The valve cranks, yeah, it does indeed. And that's made by Erika Synths. And
is it a Latvian valve?
It's
a Russian valve, probably, isn't it?
I guess so.
I think Russia still makes valves.
I'm not sure. We'd have to ask Gert.
I believe
Erika
that
Synths.
Russia is the world's only valve producer still.
I think... I'll find out. Yeah. I'll find out. So big up Erika Synths and big up Ingmar Dr. Walker, who often... often comes onto the chat here,
I've not had a play with this yet, so I'm really looking forward to it.
I think you're
given that Adrian Sherwood said it was the best delay unit in the world, I would say that's a pretty good recommendation.
Indeed, so have fun with that, mate. And it's analog as well, I don't know how you'll integrate into your setup, but you'll find a way.
Stick it in the middle, yeah.
Cool. So, quick check through the chat here, see what else we've got.
Again.
Sorry, we've got a Morris of cables here. that's better. Is my fractal still here? Yes.
I did once say to Luke that I'm always baffled as to where your samples come from, because I never recognise anything on his records.
No, apart from the odd amen, yes. But
yeah, but often it's just a complete mystery. And he looked at me, furrowed his brow and said, Charles Aznavour.
Well, as they say, today's shit is tomorrow's rare groove.
I think in general it's the 10p records of the charity shop.
Charles Aznavour. I got some, I was in a secondhand shop in Greenwich. I bought a five vinyl album, Reader's Digest. It's called Candlelight and Wine. It's nearly all shit apart from on the last one. Got like five really good string samples from the sort of day of Kenobi, you know, when that was all about having those string loops and a little beat.
That's a great sample there.
Yeah.
That's Engelbert Humperdinck, isn't it, I think, on that?
Right.
Yeah, and he actually got a credit on the record.
I think
talking of Reader's Digest,
Engelbert's probably not short of the odd lawyer or two.
No. There is a six album set of Reader's Digest, which is all organ music. And it's all absolutely worthless, except for it has an amazing track by Dick Hyman called Alfred the King of Disco.
Oh, you know, I think you've played that.
Have played it.
Yeah, we'll have to dial that one.
I think it's only on this Reader's Digest box set, so I shall be perusing the Oxfam shops until I find a copy of that.
Let's have a quick look through the chat here. Orlando Drummond's offering us, it says, I have many, many Akai era sample libraries if you want access to them. Well, thank you, Orlando, it's a nice offer, but you have access to many Emacs sample libraries, haven't you? Ramjack's got all his anyway.
Yeah, my Emacs doesn't work anymore.
But Paul's does, right?
No, I think he just sold mine, having failed to get it to work, okay. And after being okay. Even in for shop, it didn't work, so we sold it for parts, I think. It's gone.
Well, Orlando, Colcut's still got our Akai sample.
What I don't want is a Loon Garden sample.
And even our Casio library's still somewhere there in the vaults.
What I did get recently is the Sophy sample library.
Yes.
And it's pretty amazing, actually. Yeah. So yeah. I think I'm going to do a track using that.
Yeah, I think I've got to do a pack with that as well.
And I've also got the Equinox sound library, and that's got some pretty good sounds.
Oh, I haven't got that.
Oh, wow.
I've been caning them after you turned me on to Equinox.
They're great, aren't they?
Yep, I downloaded some stuff and even found them on Tidal, weirdly enough.
So you know about Tidal's announcement today?
No.
They're going to play, their streaming fees are now going to go to the artist you actually listen to, rather than just going all to Jay-Z's pocket.
Well, that's a significant change.
It is a significant change.
For one of the big they're players, Tidal.
Yeah.
For one of the big DSPs to change the model like that, that is quite revolutionary. I think that will get a lot of love from people.
There is small print. It only applies to high tier subscriptions.
Well, I read today that Tidal now, you don't have to pay extra for the sort of highest quality.
I'm not sure.
I think they must be pushing to sort of keep going. What's this one called?
This is Lovely. And this was on Virgin, wasn't it? And this was...
I might get us busted then.
Ah. Let's munge it.
Better double it out. Can you not mix it with another one?
Okay, well, in that case, the one on Mowax will get you busted too.
Of course, Mowax sold to A&M, didn't they?
Yeah, she's
a bit of a mistake.
Ah, okay, well, that one will be all right. That one's on Mowax.
Hey there, Lara Smiles, welcome. Hi there, Italian Law. Kleptomania, yes indeed. Colcut's Kleptomania on... What was the sample library? One of the first ones. Vlad. Zero G, was it? I think. Yeah, we love that. Dick Hyman version of Turn It Up. And give it up and turn it loose. I can tell you, Nick Lorne, that John used to have the only person basically on the scene with that. And he scraped the label off it and painted over it, and he just used to call it Dynatone. And he used to cane that track because Dynatone, what? I think, was the label.
Harvey did exactly that, and even worse, he actually bootlegged the track and put it out as a single on his own label without any credit.
Well, I'm afraid, Harvey, we did that before you, because we did that with Ride the Pressure. That was on the second Colcott album. Ride the Pressure was basically a huge rip-off of Give It Up or Turn It Loose by Dick Clymer. It can now be admitted, at least I hope it can be, without too much Ubiquity Lab says, yay, Zen Delay, best tool in my studio. Thank you. Mountain Dweller wants to know if the two of us ever performed with Talvin Singh.
We did that legendary. Big Chill. He was at several Big Chills.
We did that legendary jam with him, Daniel Pemberton.
You did, I didn't.
And Square Pusher. That's right. Big Chill.
And I arrived the next morning and heard all about it. I didn't participate in that.
That was a good one.
He was supposed to headline in Goa. What happened? I'm mixing up two different Big Chills. At one Big Chill, he turned up very late and missed his set in an attempt to get the headline slot. And that's a really low trick.
We'll give Talvin the benefit of the doubt.
No, I'm fairly sure. And he didn't get a set after that.
Okay. First time chat from viewer Cal Cell. Hi from San Francisco. Jasper! Hello. Is that Jasper Sharp by any chance? I wonder.
Hello, Jasper Sharp.
Well, who?
It might not be.
It might be. Anyway, whoever you are, Carl Sell, it is Jasper Sharp.
Hello.
Jonah and Billy's son. Welcome, mate. Big love to you. I didn't know you were back in the West Coast. We miss you here in London. So good to hear from you. Yeah. I've been missing lots of the chat here. Sorry. Oh, Ubiquity Lab came in with Luke Francis Vibert, but I think we're going to have to stick with our prize winner. James Gross says, loved you at the Chill Mix. Mixmaster Morris. Moog Acid. Yeah, Luke's album with Jean-Jacques Perry.
We should play something
from that.
And the one with BJ Cole.
Oh, I love that.
Yeah.
With the slide guitar guy.
Yeah. Right, yeah. But this is a strange one. This is... He had to make a single that was an 11-inch single, and apparently it cost untold thousands of pounds to press an 11-inch single. It's like, why didn't he just put it on 12-inch? It would have been so much cheaper. It was 11-inch transparent vinyl.
That's a hipster format too far, I'm afraid.
That is. All I need now is an 11-inch turntable to play it on. And it's called London is a Country.
Factor 9. This is really weird. I've quit Resolume and I'm still losing power. Oh well.
London is a country coming down from its cliffs. London is a country coming down. London is a country.
Turning up in their headphones a little bit.
Yeah.
London is a country coming down from its cliffs.
Let's have some squid.
London is a country.
Nightcafe.studio. I think I showed you this last week. Ant versus Vampire at the End of the World, that's called.
Often when you're playing Luke Vibert, don't you get the feeling, I'm not sure if this is the right speed. Definitely sounds like it could go better on 45.
Let me do a quick tap.
Oh, can I tell a wonderful thing? Taylor Swift has made an album, and in the there's an addition in Target that is 4/12 inches, so it plays a 45. All the Taylor Swift fans are buying it and then giving it one-star reviews and saying, why is there a man singing on this record? Still playing to the wrong speed. It's hilarious.
If I can mix
kids today, you know, they're not even there. Two speeds.
Unlike the old days. Anything goes. Don't worry.
109.8. Tom Middleton with a terrible threesome.
Must have been something in the water. His dad was a crazy Jimi Hendrix fan and then got into punk. His mum preferred Yves Montand and the Beatles.
And Charles Aznavour, I expect.
He went to school, his favourite subject is unknown. Young Master Vibert started playing various bands and basically making a bad noise. He puts the oddness of the Cornwall School. School spelled S-K-O-O-L. That's good, it's good, good, good. And contemporaries Aphex and Tom called Tom. In fact, they were so far from any metropolitan style police that no one really cared what they made. Do they mean place or how it sounded or what you called it? A new label called Rising High contacted Luke. They were looking for new music.
That is true.
Having convinced the label of many of the people buying his records he was a new ambient guru, Wagner Price continued to make sizzling funky chunks of exotic business, culminating in the masterful throbbing patch. Also discovered the joys of name changing. This one. Oh,
yeah.
This is I Love Acid.
This is I Love Acid, yeah. So we've now passed the 2000s on the timeline.
Play some acid visuals for this. Take a sound of this.
And that, of course, is EVA by Jean-Jacques Perry, right there.
Saying I love acid.
No, that is EVA. The first note of EVA.
I know.
Yeah.
Has he passed on, Jean-Jacques?
He has still now. With us? No, no, he got.
We met him a few years ago, a couple of times actually. He came into Ninja Tune. He was really into what me and Stuart were doing with Hex. And true innovator.
Innovator with a 70-year career in electronic music. Not many people can match that. He was making electronic music before the Second World War.
Wow. Thanks for joining us here on the Wednesday night, all you peeps out there. Big up to everyone listening on Mixcloud, Twitter, YouTube, and our two core platforms, FB and Twitch. How we got? Square Pusher is one of the best drum programmers. Yeah, I think we can agree on that, Studio Dice.
I would add Hefner
TV 303 Romance. Sorry.
I was going to say Hefner is one of the best people at drum programming I've ever heard. Do you remember the Hefner album?
Mm-hmm.
Residue.
Well, with Mixmaster as
I'm
a main...
blowing people's minds with that one because it's 20 years ago and the younger people have never heard it. And when they hear that, they just go, oh my God.
I hear people talking about, you know, the 90s revival and... to me, the 90s was just like not very long ago, but actually it is quite a long time ago.
The 90s was the most creative decade that I've ever seen, and there was all this amazing music and all these fantastic clubs, and then people say, let's remember the 90s, and they just play sort of Oasis or something, and it's like, that's not what was happening in the 90s, mate.
People say the same about the 80s, and they, you know, play all Duran Duran.
Yeah, they play Duran Duran. Yeah,
we had great soul music, we had electro. We had fantastic playing music in the 80s.
We had hip-hop.
And we had hip-hop. And we had, you know, the new wave. And
we had go-go.
Go-go. There's always...
We had Afrobeat.
There's always plenty going
on.
There is. I'm not really into saying this such and such a decade was better than the other, to be honest. It depends what if you're paying attention or not.
It's forever the same.
The vibe is always there.
It's forever the same. The riches are for those who are prepared to climb up to the highest branch.
Or dig down.
Or dig down. Can you dig it?
Okay, I suppose. I'm going to go through a bit more of our news here. And sorry, Morris, I've neglected to dig out any of your memes for this week. Yes. And Jungle, indeed, Tor Rudd said, yes, good observation. Lots of different vibrations, always constantly springing up, usually from the underground. Nick Lawrence agreeing, Hefner's an amazing producer.
This album was very, very simple.
What's that?
To listen to messages of soul with a solid beat.
Make you move the beat.
Now, the premise of this album was
to find a passing spaceship and get rescued by it. Oh, come on.
Now, the premise of this album was, well, the dance, actually. Dance business. The highest definition ever achieved in recording.
I'll even tell you what two of the secret ingredients are.
Pure electronic modern electronics.
That'll make them happy.
Pure electronic modern electronics.
Oh, lovely, do we want to get up and dance?
Pure electronic modern electronics.
Let's have a body
Pure Electronic Modern Electronics.
Sounds like Steinsky.
Pure Electronic Modern Electronics. Pure Electronic Modern Electronics. Pure Electronic Modern Electronics. Pure Electronic Modern Electronics.
The highest definition ever achieved.
There's a lot more vocals in this track,
yeah, I think that's it.
Okay, let's have a bit more news. There's the article about the Random Acts of Kindness and World Kindness Day. Still loving that. Okay, yeah, if you want to check out... Oh, I know what I was going to do. Okay, yeah, let me just quickly pick that up. Oh, I forgot to plug mirror.xyz. Okay. So, what I thought I'd do is, rather than forgetting,
supernaturally blow it up in their lives in a supernatural way for a phenomenal increase.
Okay.
Supernaturally, abundantly bless you. Open the windows of heaven and pour out abundant provisions on you today. Mom.
I'm so full of ideas, and here's a good one.
Dream Fresh has posted Free Omar Soliman into the chat. I haven't heard.
Yes, he's just been arrested by the Turkish authorities and charged with terrorism.
You're fucking joking.
Not joking, no, today's news.
Because
he's known to support the Kurdish rights, that's enough to make him a terrorist in the eyes of the...
Heavy government in Turkey, isn't it?
Yeah.
Thanks for alerting us to that, Dream Fresh. Free Omar Soliman. Well, yes, we agree.
Yeah, I saw him at Glastonbury. It was the most epic gig. Huge crowd he had.
That's us, isn't it? If I turn that down, that's better. Okay, let's take that out. Okay, I know what I was going to say. Yeah. Yeah. Okay, check Resident Advisor, says Dream Fresh. Let's move on to the next one. That's it. Yes. Okay, so there's a nice article here by my man Alex Holmes in Music Tech. And reviewing the 12 best music remixing apps. It's nice to see with, all these ones here, that, good old Ninja Tune with Jam Pro, gets a really good review here, and yeah,
quite right.
Innovative and feature-packed app that's well worth a look, so thanks for that, Music Tech. And what I was going to say was,
personally I think it's too cheap, you should put the price up.
Well, actually, when I think it was Future Music who said it should be £100, but I just thought, like, the cheaper we can make it, the more people might be into it. But sometimes reverse psychology.
Yeah, it's reverse psychology. Charge £100 and then twice a year put it down to £20 per day. People will be so happy to get a discount.
You might be right. Okay, listen, what I meant to do was, each week I get to the end of the show, forget to paste in the news items. So what I've done is I'm pasting it in now so I don't forget. So basically that is a very basic list of links of all the items that I'm talking about in the show on the news. It's just if anyone wants to take them further, there they are. Okay, so job done. All right, let's move on. MIT takes a major advance towards fusion energy. New superconducting magnet breaks magnetic field strength records, paving the way for practical commercial carbon-free power. I mean, I think that is a second part of that sentence is a little J generous, but I reckon we'll get there eventually with fusion. September the 5th, a large, high-temperature superconducting electromagnet was ramped up to a field strength of 20 tesla. That's how you measure powerful magnetic fields, actually.
Yeah, but it's normally nano tesla, so if you've got a whole tesla, that's a really big field.
That's a whole... Right, there you go. So, respect to them for getting it done. Maria Zuba, MIT's vice president. Fusion, in a lot of ways, is the ultimate clean energy source, okay? Yeah, good. The amount of energy that's available is really game-changing. Well, it would be if it worked, but yes, that's this was pretty cool. This was pretty cool. Okay, let's check out this dog. Hero Dog awarded trophy for rescuing more than 100 koalas during Australia bushfires. I regretted doing this before. Am I going to press full screen? No, I'm not. Just going to leave it like that. That's a blindfolded tightrope walking we were just looking at. Hop upstairs, okay, good.
That's pretty amazing. If anyone can train their cat to do these things, although cats can walk on tightropes, give them that.
Well, I remember seeing that Fat Freddy's Cat cartoon. He's in a bar. Suddenly comes out with, "All dogs are fascists."
Yes.
Everyone looks at him. He's like, "Anyone ever seen the police cat?
Cat.
Well, but then again, anyone ever seen a mountain rescue cat?
No. But then again, you own a dog, whereas cat owns you.
A cat can own a rumba as well, actually, so I'll demonstrate in a minute. Marty?
Unfortunately, people are now buying rumbas just so their cat can swan around. I saw a guy today putting his grandfather clock on a rumba and having it go around the house.
Time's moving on. Marty, I appreciate your friend request there, but the thing is, I only have my Facebook account purely for the purposes of running Pirate TV, being able to do Pirate TV, so that's why I've only got 5 friends, because I'm steadfastly resisting going down that road.
Yeah, and I've been kicked off Facebook, so I can't help you either.
Yeah. But I think that Facebook, let me have a quick look at my stats, I think we've got more viewers on Facebook than on Twitch this week. How's it going? Oh no, Twitch is ahead actually. Okay. It's the groove. Nice. And this is from Science. What are they called? ScienceX.com. We mapped every large solar plant on the planet using satellites and machine learning. I like this. Astonishing 82% decrease in the cost of solar photovoltaic PV energy since 2010. It's given the world fighting chance to build a zero emissions energy system, which might be less costly than the fossil fuel system it replaces. How about we just go to India and other places that are still wielding a lot of coal? Mr. Jeff Bezos, I'm talking to you, and say, like, look, it costs X to build a coal-powered power station and Y to produce a renewable energy solar-powered system of the same power. We'll give you the difference. Then not everyone in Delhi would be choking into their chai. Let's have a look at another item. I mentioned this earlier, sort of small but possibly significant step forward out of COP. Pledge cautiously welcome the first step, $1.7 billion. I mean, sort of, one thinks it's like a billion. It was Jackie Onassis who said, doesn't it? $1 million just doesn't go as far as it used to. $1 billion doesn't go as far as it used to, does it? Sort of. Anyway.
Get you test out for a couple of nights.
We'll be given directly to Indigenous people and local communities for recognition of their key role. Actually, I found an interesting article, which was in that magazine I was mentioning, Dope. I'll come back to it in a minute, about how Preston. Oh,
dread these computers. They're so naughty and so complex.
We're on to some pretty unknown albums.
Coming up to nearer to the present day.
Yeah, we're in about 2005, I think now. That last one was from an album called Shadows, and this one's from an album called We Hear You. And I must say, they're both new to me.
I like the sample. Yeah, basically, weeds are a problem, and herbicides are a problem. So a robot that uses lasers to kill 100,000 weeds an hour is a good thing.
More entertaining to watch.
Absolutely. Can we actually watch it, in fact? White talking heads, forget it. Okay, close that one. Oh yeah, I mentioned this earlier. So for any creatives out there, I came across this thanks to Vex Angel, actually, for turning me onto this. Mirror.xyz. XYZ becoming the new sort of hipster top level domain, I'd say. Because I guess it means just like, what the fuck, you know, we don't care what it means. .com, fuck all that. XYZ, but it's a sort of new crypto blockchain powered creative platform. Basically, what got me into crypto a few years ago was this thing, scenario.com. I had this idea for a community, social community, that would be owned by the members. Like, imagine if, like, we all owned Facebook, because we create it, right? All that content. Now, Scenario didn't make it, but this is a sort of similar idea. The idea is that us members and us creatives, and in fact just the audience, will own this platform. And I don't know if I quite get it, and I'm not sure if it's on a suitably clean blockchain, i.e. not Ethereum, not ERC20 powered, but something like Tezos or Cardano, or one of the decent, or Sol, one of the cleaner ones. But the idea is quite interesting. I wonder if I can even logging into my account on a public forum like this would not be a good idea. But they've sort of combined it with a gamified competition. But actually, before you had to win the competition, of which only there were only a few winners to use the tools. But now you can go on here. You can launch your own sort of Kickstarter proposal, NFTs, quite a lot of other stuff. Yeah. So this is, people are calling this Web 3.0. And the idea is to grab back the control from the big Nazi companies that have taken over the net. And for people to own it. It's a form of mutualism. So I sort of vaguely logged on, but I don't know, I'm just slowly checking it out. Anyway, if you want to go on there, you can search for me, Matt Black, and I should be there somewhere. Right, that's this week's news on Pirate TV. Marty Wells is mentioning that Shadows is utterly gorgeous. I think I did. I might play the video for that, actually. Computer. Is this near the end?
Computer. Yeah.
Oh, dread these computers. They're so...
Was that Mr. Magoo? It sounded awfully like Mr. Magoo.
Just for you, Marty, we're going to play this... Shadows. bass. Mixmaster Morris on the buttons, and myself on the fist, and a Luke Viber special sign out Wednesday night. Indeed, that's what I wanted to do. There we go, that's a bit of wavy lettering there telling you what we're about. Okay, hit it, Morris.
I saw there's a track called this Special from Designer the Song.
Of this record contains important information for radio program directors and is not for broadcast. The first cut on this record has been cross-format focused for airplay success. Special Designer Song follows in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
If you're looking for that vocal sample, it's on the Negative Land album, Escape from Noise.
Nodding along here on the Wednesday night, yeah, peeps. Thanks for coming to join us these few sessions we've been doing, Morris.
Ah, pleasure, always.
Morris doesn't live too far from the Ninja Tune hindquarters, so. And
well, last year I lived round the corner.
Yeah, well, South East London, South London.
Okay then, I went to two really good things this week, if I can mention them. One was the Hoxai exhibition at the British Museum.
Oh yes, it's new work so far.
It is, yes, it's a book, an encyclopedia he did like 108 illustrations for, and the book was never published. And all the illustrations were found in a wooden box, I think in a French book dealer's shop in Paris. And they're not signed. They couldn't be anybody else but Hoxai, though. And there is some controversy because the box is signed Hoxai, and the box seems to be a fake. And that some dealer in the past has
decided
added Hoxai's name to it.
Try and big up the authenticity.
Yeah, nonetheless, it's 100% genuine.
Okay.
And of course, these ink drawings don't normally survive because they used to make a woodcut. You put them on a block of wood and then you carve them to buggery. You get rid of 90% of, rid of all the paper.
Right.
So it's a miracle that they've survived. And if you want to go and see them, it's at the British Museum until January.
But these pictures are quite miniature, aren't they?
They're book size. They're like A4 size.
Okay. Okay.
Or a bit smaller than A4. And they're black and white. And they are small, so take your glasses.
It was good, yeah?
It's very good. I found that you could... best way to see them is to take a picture and then blow it up and put...
I was being a bit naughty.
Make it black and white, you can see it.
The Royal College of Art exhibition I mentioned the other day, I was taking pictures off the wall. Not taking, but photographing them off the wall. So it's quickly backpedaling. And then putting them into Night Cafe and doing funky shit with them. And so I might have a couple of examples here. Oh, I'm going to move this over, actually, so we can...
You've just given me an excuse to quote Emo Phillips. He tells a joke, he says, I went to the museum and they had a Van Gogh painting and it said, loaned anonymously. So I went to the desk and said, it was me, can I have it back?
He said... I like to play chess with old men in the park, but it can be hard to find 32 of them.
Yes.
I might have told that one already. Well, he definitely did. Okay, so I'm going to show this.
He also said, my brother says hello, so hooray for speech therapy.
He also said, my cousin phoned up, he said, I found Jesus. I thought, woohoo, we're rich. Turns out he meant something else.
Another favourite, he said, when I was a kid, I used to pray every day for a new bicycle. And then I found out that the Lord doesn't work that way, so I just stole one and asked him to forgive me.
Naughty. Okay, this is the cover of that magazine I was mentioning. Oh, okay. Why did you come in weirdly upside down like that when I... didn't ask you to. Rotate, escape. Street Lee, this is for you. That'll work. That's too big. Escape, there we go. It's down there a little bit. There we go. Yeah, that's Dope Magazine. It's just a cover, which is perhaps isn't that incredible, although it's quite decent, but the article inside were wicked, and I'm still perusing it. In fact, I posted a couple. Okay, here's a little quote I'll give you as we're on this tip. They were talking about the Preston model. Preston is a town in the north of England that's sort of been notoriously poor. A few years ago, they decided to fuck off spending all the money they're supposed to spend on regeneration on sort of corporations and outside companies and do it themselves. The Preston model has taken the city from being one of the country's most deprived and disadvantaged to seeing significant economic improvement through shifting its own spending and investment from external suppliers to local producers and businesses. By 2020, Preston has achieved its highest employment rate and lowest levels of economic inactivity for over 15 years. In 2018, it was voted the UK's most improved city to live and work. Check this out. Notably, the material development delivered by Preston's... shall I get a bit of dub on it? Delivered by Preston's strategy has brought consistent political success. In the 2019 general election, Preston was one of the few constituencies to buck the national trend swing that saw a lot of heavy losses for Labour. And Labour did very well there. In this year's local elections, Labour in Preston again defied national trends, retaining all its council seats and increasing its share in others. Preston has become a beacon for the strategy of community wealth building. So that's what happens when you don't give all the money to the government's mates who say they'll sort things out and don't.
Randocks or someone, so, yes.
Yeah, instead spend it locally and get local institutions and communities and people on board. Miracles can be created.
However, Preston is officially the rainiest place in the UK.
And that's all and the more reason for them to get it right and pick themselves
not
up.
Even the Labour Party can fix that.
You rained on my parade.
And I think Leeds is second.
Anyway, I thought that was very interesting, and I also thought the next article, which is about mutualism and mutual aid, is very interesting as well. I shall report on that next week when I've read up on it a bit more. But Kropotkin is one of the dudes mentioned. A lot of ideas in the Victorian era. A favourite riff of mine, that social Darwinism and capitalism overemphasise competition and don't give enough space to cooperation, for example, as indeed I think I might have said in this little, text that says something like that. Yes, here we go.
So this one is the title track from an album called Rhythmic, and again, this one is new to me. I think 2017.
Seeing the same old thing done in the same old style, the same old time after time. Seeing the same old thing done in the same old style. The
competition
same old
and cooperation.
Time after time.
Are the yin and yang of evolution.
Same old story, a new way. Same old story, a new way. Same old story, a new way. Same old story, a new way.
Oh, can I give a shout out to Jeff and to Ken and to Doug, all of whom I think are tuned in from South London,
if you'd like to help someone,
and who've been
help someone
looking after me during the lockdown.
Teacher or two who have your kind of imagination.
Yep. Ken, Jeff and Doug, the Mixmaster Morris support bubble, and good friends of mine as well. Big up to you. Thanks for everything you do, keeping us sane.
Is this machine recording?
And Monday night I went to see a gig, which was the mighty Lewis Cole of Brainfeeder fame.
Nice.
And I noticed a much bigger crowd the last time, and that all the audience know all the words to all the songs now.
Bigger crowd than last time.
Yeah, right? About 1,000 this time.
Where was that again?
At Earth in Hackney.
Great.
Is this machine? Is this machine?
And if you haven't checked out Lewis Cole, please go and do so and get the album Time. It was my favourite album of the year in 2019, wasn't it? Yeah.
Was that on Brainfeeder?
Yeah.
Great. Big up Brainfeeder, big up Flylow, nice one.
And Lewis Cole has a band as well called Noah, K-N-O-W-E-R, and that's also fantastic, and I believe that he's going to tour that as well when he's finished this tour. He's another guy of just incredible output and just never stops creating.
Yeah, we must become more productive as well.
Well,
you're working on it.
We're both
right?
Pretty productive, yeah?
Yeah, yeah.
Given that I've usually got 5 mixes in the top 10 in every single chart and Mixcloud every day.
Right, we'll allow you a quick...
I have to slow down in order to let people catch up with me.
We'll let you have a quick plug for Mixmaster Morris on Mixcloud, where you can check out a rather extensive and excellent collection of mixes, and indeed a curated selection of probably some of the best in music of all.
And in fact, today, number styles. 1 in the jazz chart, the funk chart and the soul chart.
Very good. I need to get in there and give you some competition.
Yep. I see Youth has been giving me some competition.
I saw he's number 1 in the psychedelic chart.
Right.
This new thing, which
is that's because I didn't tag psychedelic in my mix. The 808 State mix was number 1 on the Acid House chart for the last 7 days, in fact, which is the maximum.
Okay. Very good. Yeah, I mean,
We're running short of time now.
We are, and actually I've been naughtily not saying hello to everyone. What's happened to my chat panels? Apologies for not catching up with the chat here. So, lots of nice pirates saying cool and interesting things. What is the best track by Cold Cut? No idea, Robert. You tell me. Monio 888 was saying I was using Ninja Jam with my six-year-old daughter today. She loved it. Brilliant. Glad to hear it. Mr. Raid, nice to hear from you. Lilith the Mycera says this has to be like a genome doggo. Yeah, well, you mean like super genetically programmed, maybe. Could be. What's the best trick for receiving a cookie? 8 hours of job, 5 days a week, says Robert. Yeah.
This one reminds me of the days of stealth, because we used to play this a lot, and it's on your mix album, isn't it? Extreme Possibilities.
Yeah, this is Daniel Pemberton.
Yeah.
And John Ty, right?
Oh, so I have a new album released, I have a new record released in Germany today from a Japanese label, and Daniel Pemberton's on that, so small world.
Cool, what's the Along, release?
I've just seen the title, and now I'm trying to remember the title. In, Out, Over, or Up, Down, Under, something like that. In, Out, it
always,
it's on the APL label, Advanced Public Listening, and is all exclusive tracks, and in fact has the first new Irresistible Force track for a while.
Ah, this is the new one you were telling me about. Oh, I've got to hear that. Oh, we'll play it next show. You
play
do
the
we'll
next
catch
show
up.
Yeah.
Okay, Chromie Pants wants a little Negative Land. We'll
You just have some.
What, the sample, you mean?
Yeah, there's a whole track.
We'll bear that in mind there, Chromie Pants. And Low Tank Clan, glad you could make it there, mate. Goody.
I did a gig with Negative Land in San Francisco once, which was pretty wild.
I've met them as well.
Yeah. Sadly, I think most of them are not with us now, I think.
Preston is famous for
the end.
Is it right?
Really? Yeah. Don Joyce died.
Preston is famous for its chartists, says Lilith. Okay. Yeah, lots of love here for the Mixmaster. Thank you, Terry the Ghost, who is...
I've played this record at 33 for many years.
Yeah.
But this is 45. So I'm one... That can't possibly be the right speed.
No, that's not the right speed. Double Jungle.
Yes.
Terry the Ghost is saying hello to you, Morris. That is, I think, our good friend, Mike. Cool video with Luke Vibert, Aphex Twin, and John Ty. John Peel.
Oh, yes. Well, talking of John Peel, we have a John Peel session from Luke Vibert, don't we? So let me find that. Here it is, and let's see what the track REO Speed Garage sounds like. Oh.
Oh, look, I've got to ban this person now. How can I ban them? Oh, well, never mind, I'll bother. Hopefully they'll just fuck off. Right. Nice one, Rob Wood. Kropotkin, good bit of anarcho-communism to dive into. Yes, indeed. So this is it?
Yeah, this is from 98.
From the Peel session,
from the Peel session, yeah. I don't think this is released. I would dearly love to release my Peel sessions.
Have you got the recording?
I've got one of them.
Love it.
Ooh.
I know that song for what is that?
It's Radiophonics Workshop. It is John Baker from Radiophonics Workshop.
Going on about being funky.
No, those electronic sounds, because I did a track with some of those sounds myself, so I know it exactly. I think the track is Brio by John Baker from about 1964. They're great sounds, aren't they?
We've got given that collection as well from Radiophonic.
Great title, REO Speed Garage is the title of it. That's Wagon Christ, Luke Vibert.
Sweet. We miss him. We miss you, John. We do.
We do. 10 years now. And this one is amusingly called My Organ in Your Face. That'll do it, I think. That's 5 minutes.
Luke's been tuning in. I think he might have been secretly lurking there watching it, no doubt. Hopefully we'll be enjoying more fresh music from Wagon Christ.
I've just remembered when Aphex Twin made Window Licker.
Yeah.
And they had the premiere at a West End cinema, Piccadilly Circus. And they made the whole cinema wait for about 3 hours, during which Luke did a DJ set. And then they showed the video, and the whole place just went absolutely bananas. It was the full, 12-minute version.
Yeah, beautiful work.
That was a great night out.
I mean, that video is Chris Cunningham, isn't it?
It is, yes.
I think, I've always rated Richard as a fantastic talent, but that video, I think, amplified him by times 10.
It did. Personally, I'd like to see some more records up to that high standard.
More videos, you mean?
Well, both, yeah.
Yeah, well, call up Chris then.
Tell Gwen to tell Richard to get his ass in gear. Oh, one Luke Vibert
project we should mention is the Nuggets album.
Oh, yeah.
He did three albums.
This with John Tye, isn't it?
Yeah, Luke Vibert's Nuggets, Luke Vibert's Further Nuggets, and a Volume 3. And they're all obscure library music, mostly European, excellently chosen. Probably to buy the records of each of those albums would cost you in excess of £1,000. So, in fact, even the Luke's compilations are now extremely collectible, and the price has shot up for those. So, if you're into library music, you know you can hear them on Spotify, I'm sure.
I know the ones. Actually, I had them. I think like a year or so before they were released. Bye, John.
Put one on to finish you. Yeah, we should have an Alan Hawkshaw show.
Well, plenty of time. Next time. What's that like, animating? This should be animating. Come on.
Now here's a track from one of those albums. This is the wonderfully named Roger Roger. Well, being French, he's probably Roger Roger. It's a rather strange track. I know there is some great Roger Roger albums. I found three of them. I found three Roger Roger albums at a charity shop. I was so excited, but they are terrible. They are from like the 90s and they're awful. So I think he won things before about 1980.
I don't know anything about him.
He's a French library composer, of whom there are very many.
Yes, Montparnasse 2000. Do you know that label?
Yeah, Jean-Jacques Perry did a record for them.
Montparnasse 2000. Gwen was well into that.
Library. No, French music, I've got separately. French library music.
Ooh, that's nice, isn't it?
Claude Pelequin, Guy Boyer, Fabriano Fusion. His three... Fabriano Fusion, he doesn't look very French. The other two are French. He's on a French label.
I've got to read this out. Ruff Ruff. Very funny, Morris blowing his trumpet about his number one mixes and playing the record at the wrong speed.
Well, the MP3 file has been recorded at 45.
It's not his fault.
That's what happens when you download things and don't check them.
Mr. Aid, we did have a competition earlier, and we had a pretty cool prize. But we shall endeavour to still pick up the prizes and competitions again in the future. Sorry, I let that lapse for a good few months now.
We're running
out of time. I'm about to run out of battery as it goes, so I'm going to come out of the tunnel.
Oh, and if you like French electronic music, the legendary Richard Pinhas, Pinhas, before you start laughing, of Helden fame is about to do a gig in London, I think, for the first time in 40 years or something. I think it's after Christmas, but if you want to get a ticket, I would get that now because it's going to sell out.
Sounds like a good one. I'll see you there. Okay, pod people, it has been a pleasure to be here entertaining you for a couple of hours. Big thanks to Mixmaster once more stepping in, and we will continue sparking you up hopefully next Wednesday, and we'll get that thing working. But actually, I mean, when I'm in town, you might as well come here and then we can hang out. But if I'm in the country, then we could get a remote set like we were working out the other day. And it's all good. And thanks very much for you tuning in. You are the Pirates. Hey there, Ken. Welcome. In time to get your big up there. Armtone from St. Petersburg. Lots of good Pirates in the house. Our Podfathers, thank you, Marty Wells, to you. And what's the one with the kids or with Aphex Twin's face? Come to Daddy, isn't it? Georgina wants to know. Well, the video with the kids, all the kids have got Aphex's faces.
Yeah, maybe. It's another of the Cunningham ones.
It's another of the Chris Cunningham ones. And with that, we're going to tune out and we'll send you super hugs and wishes for a fantastic week and much love, sign-ups to sign-ups. That is the way we do it. You can still mail us jampro1000@gmail.com if you want to, but we shall carry on regardless. Yeah, wishing you one love and a warm week. And I'm going to stop streaming because I always get this wrong. Go on.
One more thing. I'm down in Hastings this weekend at the Hempist Hemp Cafe. And I'll be playing on Saturday and Sunday. And I think it's free. And you can come and eat hemp burgers and listen. I think Lol Hammond is playing with me on the Sunday.
Great. Well, if anyone's in the area, that sounds good. Okay. All right, people. Much love. We shall see you anon.